here with Diana Limongi, also known as Lady D in the interwebs, and she's a mommy. So she had some questions about her little five-year-old, and I thought that, you know, a lot of you probably have the same questions. So let's get going. Go ahead.
Okay, so thank you. I'm super excited to be here, by the way. So my first question is, how do I get my son to clean up his toys without having to repeat it 5 times, which is what I have to do now all the time?
Okay, so
he gets distracted, like
two things. Timer. Timer, timer, timer. Whether on your phone or whether from Bed Bath & Beyond.
Like, do I say you have three minutes to pick up?
You say, buddy, you have 5 minutes to pick up. I'm going to put the timer. When the timer goes off, you have to start picking up, right?
Oh, you have to start picking up. Okay.
Right.
So like, you have 5 minutes to play.
To wrap up.
Okay.
To wrap up your story. Okay. And the more empathic you can be about it, the better. I know that you're having a big, wonderful story with your toys, but in 5 minutes, we have to stop.
Okay.
So I'm going to set the timer, and when it goes off, it's going to stop. When you hear the timer, a lot of parents go, okay, it's time to clean up. But then you're screaming from across the room.
Okay. Don't know screaming.
Okay. Scream once.
Okay.
Then walk over and say, hi, it's time to clean up.
Okay.
Especially for children younger than 6.
Okay.
You really have to go to them.
Okay.
Now, if they don't listen, mm-hmm. I love this little tool called the Saturday box.
Okay.
So you have a box that you say, okay, whatever you don't pick up, I'm gonna put in the box. And you don't get this toy again.
That's
until
brilliant.
Saturday.
Oh my God, that's so smart.
But you have to give them the opportunity to begin to clean up.
Because
right?
I'm sure other parents do what I've done in the past, which is if you don't pick up whatever's on the floor, like, I'm going to throw it out.
Right.
And it's really hard because my husband has said that to him, and I'm like, you can't say that because we're really not throwing it out. You know?
Don't ever say something that you are not going to do. Don't
yes.
ever set a boundary and not be able to do it. So
then
many
they
people,
know
yeah.
that you're not going to follow. I know.
Yeah. So, okay. so, but the Saturday box is totally doable. You put the toys in there. And parents always ask me, what if it's Friday? Do we have to wait until the following Saturday? No. Saturday box is Saturday box.
Okay.
Okay. But timer and Saturday box are great ways to help your children learn to clean up. Know that cleaning up their toys is really difficult because all of them, until about 11 years old, are practicing and learning to delay gratification. So it's really difficult to stop when you are in the middle of really fun play.
Okay. That's brilliant. I'm going to try it. And I'm going to tell you what happens.
Okay.
Saturday box. And we're going to decorate the Saturday box. Oh, it's going to be, you can do an art activity. Decorate the Saturday box. Brilliant.
Okay. Yes. There you go.
Okay.